At the time of this video's production, 122 747-8s are flying. While the freighter version of the 747-8 officially finished in January, the last passenger jumbo was delivered to Korean Air in 2017. It remains in regular passenger service alongside 24 other 747-8s operating long-haul transatlantic and transpacific routes. Air China continues to operate two, Korean Air keeps 8 in its fleet, while the largest operator, Lufthansa, has 15 of the last generation super jumbos. The 747-8 freighter variant found significantly more success, and 107 of the type were built for the busy international cargo market. 89 are currently active, operated by major carriers including Atlas Air, Cargo Lux, UPS, and Cathay Pacific Cargo. 13 remain in storage. An additional 8 747-8 Boeing Business Jets, or BBJs, are listed as active, serving as VIP transport for governments or royal families. Qatar Emiri Flight operates 3, while Kuwait Airways, Oman Royal Flight, Royal Air Maroc, the Sultan of Brunei's Flight, and Turkish Airlines hold 1 each. One BBJ initially set to go to the late Saudi Crown Prince Sultan bin Abdulaziz Al Saud was scrapped in Arizona late last year after Boeing failed to find a new customer for it. Two more 747-8s set for the United States Air Force are undergoing modification. 191 747-400s are flying. The 747-400, which launched in 1988, remains the most popular variant to date, with 694 built. Excluding General Electric's testbed jet, 24 747-400 passenger jets remain active, though only 10 are in regular passenger service. The largest operator is Lufthansa, which operates the -400 on Asia and American-bound services out of its hub at Frankfurt. Asiana operates one very lonely 747-400. This jet is used primarily on high-demand routes from Seoul to Shanghai and Changchun. The oldest passenger variant still in operation serves Iran's Mahan Air. It only currently sees service between Tehran and Moscow, though occasionally can be spotted dropping in at Istanbul Airport, Baghdad, and Beijing. 13 passenger -400s are currently in VIP service for government and military transport. They primarily fly in the Middle East, though 5 remain in service in China, Korea, and the United States. The remaining 747-400, nicknamed Cosmic Girl, has found an exciting second life, refitted as a first-stage satellite launch platform for Virgin Orbit. Of the 191 -400s flying, 166 of these are -400F. Major cargo operators include Kalita Air, Air Atlanta Europe, and Atlas Air, which also operates the enlarged 747-400 LCF. Moving on, just one 747-300 remains in service today as VIP transport for Saudi Arabian Royal Flight. The 39-year-old aircraft appears to have limited use, although the jet's operating hours have not been made public. When it comes to the 747-100, 2 are listed as flying with the Islamic Republic of Iran's Air Force. As for the -200, 12 are still flying. Many are active military aircraft, with two notable jumbos being the US Air Force's VC-25A Air Force Ones. Most -200s have found second lives as freighters or testbeds, while 2 continue to be operated in Iran, one by Iran's Air Force and another for Iran Air. And finally, 3 shortened 747SP aircraft are still active. 2 are with Pratt & Whitney Canada as testbeds, while one former TWA jet has served as VIP transport for Las Vegas Sands since 2007. Do you think you'll get to fly on a 747 this year? Let us know in the comments. In addition to our daily YouTube videos, Simple Flying publishes over 150 articles every week. If you're looking for the latest aviation news and insights, visit simpleflying.com.